I've always had a deep fascination for Neanderthals. Who were our distant cousins? What was their life like? And ultimately, what caused their final demise? For 1 week, I've been given unique access to a cave in southwest France that was once home to our distant cousins, the Neanderthal. Guided by a team of archaeologists from the University of Leiden in the Netherlands and led by Professor Marie Soressi, and by using some drama reconstructions with actors, I want to go back to a time when we were not the only human-like species to walk the planet. How did early humans interact with Neanderthals? And ultimately, what caused their physical demise? Or are they still living on in us today? And I'm going to spend some time with a team of archaeologists as they unearth our Neanderthal legacy.
Why do I dig? First of all, because I love it, because it's exciting and you never know what you're going to find. I think this is something that's really, really exciting. So every time you scrape your trowel across that dirt, something could pop up that could change our image of the past immensely, in ways very childlike almost. I mean, playing with dirt, and it's, I think for me, a really nice mixture of childlike curiosity with cutting edge science.
And those yellow labels are reference points.
French Professor Marie Soressi was the passion and the brains behind the project. She was the one that had invited me into the world of archaeology.
The core of our research at the cave is to reconstruct what happened in between now, today, and the moment when Neanderthals left the cave. That was 40,000 years ago. So in between us today and 40,000 years ago, many things happened.
So 40,000 years ago seemed a pivotal point in our early evolution. This is when the first modern humans came into Europe and started interactions with the native Neanderthal species. And it's that hypothesis that contributed to who we are today.
So we have this conception of Neanderthals as kind of brutish Ice Age hunter-gatherers, which maybe didn't indulge too much in complex behavior. We're learning through multiple lines of evidence that they were actually much more like us than we ever thought in the past.
We have a tendency to think that the humans who are here today, Homo sapiens, must have been superior to the humans who disappeared. We think, when we think superior, we think cognitively superior. We do not have evidence for this.
Understanding time is probably one of the most important questions when it comes to archaeology. So dating is key. To do this, C14 carbon dating is used on organic material such as bones. On top of this, the team have another technique which I found fascinating. They are able to date the sediment where the artifacts were found in, the last time the sediment saw sunlight.
We are going to site at night because we want to take samples to date the sediment. And the technique we use measure the last moment the sediment saw the light.
And to do that, they have to do it at night using infrared. If they excavated in sunlight, they would be dating today.
It's incredible lying in the back of the cave. You really do seem to be in the heart of the life that would have been existing here thousands, tens of thousands of years ago. This is the core part of archaeology, and it's really a privilege to be connected so deeply with our past, that your life is really just a flash, just a heartbeat in what has gone in the past, what has happened in the past, the millions of years that have turned. It's quite humbling actually being in such a unique spot. Quite special. Thank you, Miriam.
Thank you. It was very nice.
For allowing me into your world of archaeology.
You're welcome.
Neanderthals and early humans are so genetically close, they were able to interbreed. Which is why today some of us are still carrying Neanderthal DNA. Something I find mind-blowing.
I did a DNA test and I have 4% of Neanderthal genes. So actually I have more than the mean. I am more Neanderthal than the average European.
But as a layperson, I wanted to understand what happened to the Neanderthals and ultimately what drove them to extinction.
We are the last species left. We shared the earth with people who were different to us. And now we are the last ones. We're the last ones left. It is sad in ways that, because in many ways we've lost a lot of diversity. I mean, and it's something that we can never really see again. So we only see glimpses of it by doing archaeology and by looking at artifacts and trying to understand how these people were behaving. But it is sad that for 3 million years, people either very much like us or perhaps very different to us inhabited this world, left traces of their behavior, and the reality of which we will never see. In a lot of ways, we try and summarize their disappearance with broad brush approaches. So we like to say things like climate killed the Neanderthals or competitive exclusion killed the Neanderthals. This is a process that went on for 6,000-7,000 years and was probably very different in different periods and in different places. I mean, in some locations there was war, in others there was probably love, there was probably kinship and networking, there was also violence, and in some places they probably never encountered each other. I mean, I think what's really important is to avoid these kind of meta-narrative or broad brush approaches when we discuss things like this, like the disappearance of a population of people.
Even though their DNA still lives on in us.
Evidence is increasingly indicating that perhaps what happened is that the Neanderthal population of Europe was effectively absorbed into the population of modern humans who migrated into Europe around 40,000 years ago.
As my time at the cave grew to an end, many thoughts had entered my mind. A lament for what we once had, and that we are the last species left. But as for our own legacy, how will archaeologists and history judge us?
You know, everything that we do in our lives leaves a footprint, a fingerprint. For future archaeologists, for future investigators to come across and stumble and analyze and wonder what were these people doing in the 21st century. And I just can't stop thinking about plastic, because we use it in every part of our life. And I kind of wonder, in the future, will archaeologists be going through a layer of sediment going, okay, here's a plastic fork, here's a bottle top, here's a plastic straw. You know, in the same way that Neanderthals and early humans were making flint spears, and we're trying to understand their past, for our future, is that our legacy? The age of plastic? It's something that we can all think about. What legacy, what archaeological legacy are we leaving behind? Because, you know, every action has a reaction for the future. It's a really profound question that I'm searching with. So interesting, just to kind of get a grips of what our future will bring.